Let's write data from a Flutter app to the Firestore Cloud database. To get started, we go to console-firebase-google.com where you need to create a Firebase project, and I have shown you in the last video exactly all the steps how to create this project. And now we go to Firestore database. Then you click on create database. Make sure to select start in test mode and click on next. Next, you can choose the server location of your Firebase server. I will simply go with the default settings and click on enable. After some loading time, you can create a new collection. I call it users and click on next. And inside this collection, you can create documents, and I create a document with a field name and the value. I give it, for example, Emma as a name, and click on save. As a result, we have a new document with a document ID. And inside this document, we store one key value pair. In this case, we store the value Emma. The next document we want to create through our Flutter app. Therefore, in your pubspec YAML file under your dependencies, add the Cloud Firestore package. Next, within the Flutter app, we create an app bar with a text field and an icon button. And now if we type anything inside of our text field, then we want to send it to Firebase if we click on this button. Therefore, let's add a text editing controller to our text field so that we can access the value of our text field, in this case, the name Emma. And lastly, we create a new method createUser where we put the name inside. And inside this method, we want to write our username to the Firebase collection users. And therefore, we create a new document with some custom ID. And now we can use this document reference to write our data inside. Therefore, I create a new map. And inside of this map, we can add key value pairs. So in this case, I put the name inside that we have typed in our text field. And you can also add some more data inside. Next, we can use the docuser reference to create this document and also put this JSON data inside. Let's try it out and write a name to our text field and click on this button. And with this, it creates a new document with the document ID MyID. And inside this document, we put all the user data inside. So basically, one document represents one single user, and we can put multiple documents inside of one collection. In case you work with model objects in your Flutter project, then we can also replace this JSON map by a user object. And here I also put an ID inside. So this is the document ID. Right now it is my ID. However, you can also remove this my ID, then he will generate an ID automatically for you. And we can access the generated ID from our document. Next, to convert this user object to some JSON data, therefore we need to create this toJSON method inside of our model object. And inside of it, we create then a map with all the keys and also value pairs for each of our fields that we have inside of our model object. Let's also try it out and let's write the model object to Firebase. And you see he has created a new document with our user. And here is our name inside, the birthday, age, and also we have put the ID inside, which is the document ID from our document. Optionally, you can create a user page, and within the scaffold body property, you can create then multiple text fields, and below the text fields, you can create an elevated button. Next, we add some text editing controllers in our state, and each of these text editing controller we want to attach then to all of our text fields. And lastly, if we click on this button, then we want to write our user data to the Firebase database. Therefore, let's go to the elevated button, and if we press on it, then we create first of all a new user object, and we access over all of our controllers and the values of our text fields. And then we only need to write this user data to our Firebase server. Therefore, we use the createUser method, put our user object inside. And finally, we put then this user object to some JSON data and put it inside of our document user, inside of our users collection. And with this, we have a great form UI and we can send this data easily to our Firebase server. And this will be then stored inside of our Firebase database.